Now, there's a situation you should be aware of with regard to the names of PI tags in Excel spreadsheets. See these tag names that we see right here? Those are hard-coded in the cell. If you notice, when I double-click on that, I mean, that's just a text box or a text field inside a cell in Excel. Now, what happens if the PI tag name that we've pasted here, what if that tag name changes? See, all of these retrievals that we see here, all of them are based on that tag name. So if the name of the PI tag changes so that all of a sudden that tag no longer exists with that tag name on that system, then these spreadsheets here are going to have a problem. So we've got a couple of ways of handling that. One way to handle this would be to use not the name of the tag in your spreadsheet, but the point ID. Now, what is the point ID? Let's take a look. If you do a tag search for, let's say, the tag CDT158 that I've just found here, if we look at the point attributes, one of its attributes is called point ID. That point ID, in this case 3, that's going to be a unique identifier that never changes for that tag, no matter what you do to the name of the tag. It's always going to be 3. So one of the things I could do is instead of hard coding the tag name here, I could set up a field here, and I could even hide this column when I'm finished with it. I can put the point ID here and then go here into the PI tag where I'd normally just hard code the tag name and use this function right here. It's called PointIDToTag. Go ahead and select this. My point ID is going to be a reference to here, and my output goes straight to here. Now, as you can see, it just changed. Well, it only changed it because now the output, yeah, there we go. The output is the output of this function. It's no longer the hard-coded text that I typed in there. Okay, so let's see how we can do this a little bit easier for all of these tags here instead of just looking them up like I just did. Let me get rid of this. I'll get rid of this, and I'll just type this back in here like it was before. So in order to do this, what I'd like to demonstrate is, first of all, let's retrieve all of the point IDs. I'm just going to put them over here temporarily. I'm going to do that by choosing tag attributes. Tag attributes takes the names of the tags and the attribute you're interested in. I'm interested in the attribute called point ID. There we go. Those are my point IDs. It's formatted a little bit oddly, but that's fine. Now, that point ID, once I've gotten that, let me copy this over here. I'm just going to copy this. I'll do an edit copy. And I'll do a paste special. I'm just going to paste the values right here. And bear with me for a second. Yeah, so now we have the point IDs right there. With the point IDs there, I don't need this anymore. I'm going to get rid of that. And also, I don't need these tags anymore. Now, when you remove those tags, notice the rest of your spreadsheet falls apart, but that won't be for long because we're about to put those tags back in there. Except this time, they're going to be indexed based on the point ID, not on the name of the tag. It's a way of avoiding hard coding the tag name. So this is where this point ID to tag comes in handy. I'll choose point ID to tag. The point IDs are over here. And I'll just go ahead and say OK. Now, that went ahead and retrieved the tag names. Those tag names, of course, being populated there, they repopulate the rest of your spreadsheet. And the beauty of this now, I'll just, you know, all I need to do is maybe hide this column. The user's not even going to notice that what, in fact, he's looking at is a result of a lookup to the point ID table. Now, a second way we could handle this issue of, you know, the hard coding tag names is we could use this attribute mask to tag to retrieve a search result based on, you know, certain attributes that you're searching for. Let me go ahead and demonstrate. Let me delete this. So we'll be back in that situation where we don't have any tag names. Now we need to add some tag names. Here's what I can do. I can just provide some search criteria. Oh, let's just put it right here. BA with an asterisk. And I'll look for the word reactor with an asterisk on both sides. And this is going to be, we'll say this is the tag, this is the descriptor. I'm just putting these here as labels. Now, these two fields now will become my search criteria for what tag results I'm going to find and then deposit over here in this range here. So, yeah, these are going to be my inputs for tag and descriptor, and I can add more. And now I'm going to choose attribute mask to tag. I'll put the cursor right here. That's where my output will appear. Attribute mask to tag allows me to search for things by any of these attributes and then outputs the names of the tags that match that criteria. So for my tag names, I'm going to choose that. For my descriptor, I'll make a cell reference to that. Now the big finish should be, when I click on OK, yeah, there we go. Now, what we're seeing here is not a specific list of tags, it's the search result that we get from these two criteria right here. And that ends up populating my spreadsheet. Again, this can be useful if you anticipate that your tag names will actually change. Because now we're just indexing this based on these search results. Again, that's referring to this over here. Now, if I can demonstrate changes to this, let's do a couple of changes. First of all, change the descriptor so that we have all results. Now, when I change the descriptor to just a single wildcard character, you notice this resize note. Yeah, we get the resize note to tell us that we've got more results. We've got more results there, more than we can use, actually. We don't really need all those results. But now, if I were to change this to a different criteria here, like, for example, CD, see, now these are just the tags that begin with the letters CD. SI for all the tags that begin with the letter SI, etc.